For today's week, we will perform the experiment on compound pendulum. Okay, and the objective of the experiment is to determine the value of acceleration due to gravity, and also determine the radius of gyration using a bar pendulum. Okay, so this object here that you're seeing on your slide, this is the bar pendulum. Okay, so previously in school, you might have dealt with the motion of a simple pendulum in which you have a string that is tied at one end, and on the other end, you have some mass that is attached, okay, M, and then we let the mass oscillate, okay, so we let it oscillate, and once it does oscillations, we record the time period. And that time period is related to some length of the pendulum, okay? And it is related to the acceleration due to gravity. What is the value for time period for a simple pendulum?
2π√L/g।
Very good. 2 pi root L over g, है ना? So if you make a simple pendulum oscillate and you record the time of the oscillations, then you can find acceleration due to gravity. Now we are going to apply a very similar idea here as well. Okay, the difference is that when you're dealing with simple pendulum, all the mass is concentrated at one point. Okay, at this position. Okay, we consider that the string is massless. Okay, now we have a continuous object. Okay, with some mass distribution. Okay, and for this continuous mass distribution, we want to see when this object is doing rotational motion, because this oscillation, you can assume that this oscillation is just part of a rotational motion, right? And we want to see that how the mass distribution comes into picture when you make an object oscillate at different positions of the length from its center of gravity. If you look at the equipment that is available in the lab, okay, so you can see that it is doing some oscillations. And if you notice carefully, there are some holes that are essentially equidistant from each other. Okay, so each of this hole is basically 5 centimeters apart. Okay, and so we have here, so you can see there is a knife edge on which this object is basically doing the oscillations. Okay, so there is this V-shaped knife edge on which it is doing oscillations. Okay, and once it does the oscillations, we can record the time period for these oscillations. Okay, so during the experiment, what we are going to do is we are going to change this position of where the pivot point is. Okay, so we'll start with one end and then we'll move this point down here by 5 centimeters. Then we'll move again down here 5 centimeters. And so at different positions from the center of gravity of this object, we will try to create the oscillations. Okay, so we have an object. It is a continuous object. It has some holes which are very equidistant. Okay, and what we are going to do is we are going to oscillate this object at each of these pivot points. Okay, and if you notice carefully, this object has essentially about 19 holes. Okay, so that means if you count 9 holes on the top and 9 holes on the bottom, then the 10th hole is exactly where the center of gravity of this object is lying. Okay, and so we are trying to make the oscillations away from the center of gravity, and that is what is your radius of gyration from the point of where this object is oscillating. So before we do that, let's try to see what the relationship is for the time period and acceleration due to gravity in the case of a compound pendulum. Let's assume you have an object of some irregular shape like this, okay? And let's say G is the point of this center of gravity, okay? So we had dealt with this before. Remember, center of gravity is that special point on which you can feel like the entire mass is concentrated. So if you try to oscillate this object at certain point P where it is fixed, then your force of acceleration due to gravity will be acting in this direction mg. Okay, and this is your point of center of gravity. दिस इज योर पिवट पॉइंट फ्रॉम विच यू आर ट्राइंग टू ऑसिलेट द ऑब्जेक्ट. ओके, सो इफ आई गिव इट्स अ सर्टन डिस्प्लेसमेंट फ्रॉम इट्स नेचुरल पोजिशन, ओके, विच इज प्रॉब्ली समवेयर हियर, वट विल हैपन, देर विल बी अ टॉर्क दैट विल बी एक्टिंग. ओके, सो देर विल बी अ टॉर्क दैट विल बी एक्टिंग, एंड वट विल द टॉर्क टू, इट विल ट्राई टू क्रिएट रोटेशनल मोशन, एंड दिस रोटेशनल मोशन विल मेक दिस ऑब्जेक्ट ऑसिलेट बैक एंड फोर्थ जस्ट लाइक यू सॉ इन द वीडियो. ओके, सो वी आर डिस्प्लेसिंग इट बाय सर्टन एंगल. ओके, दैट एंगल इज थीटा एंगल, इट इज मेंशनड हियर. ओके, एंड देन रिस्टोरिंग टॉर्क विल एक्ट एंड मेक द ऑब्जेक्ट ऑसिलेट, राइट? सो वी नो टॉर्क इज आर क्रॉस एफ, राइट? दैट इज आर फॉर्मूला फॉर टॉर्क. ओके, सो हियर द वैल्यू ऑफ आर फ्रॉम दिस पिवट पॉइंट टू दिस सेंटर ऑफ ग्रेविटी इज दिस स्मॉल वैल्यू एल. ओके, सो वी हैव द वैल्यू ऑफ एल एंड वी हैव द वैल्यू ऑफ एफ एंड द फोर्स दैट इज एक्टिंग ऑन दिस ऑब्जेक्ट इज द एक्सेलरेशन, इज द ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स. सो वी हैव आर वैल्यू ऑफ एम जी. ओके, एंड सो लेट्स ट्राई टू फाइंड द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ टॉर्क. सो इट विल बी एल टाइम्स एम टाइम्स जी टाइम्स साइन ऑफ द एंगल बिटवीन दैम. ओके, सो एल एम जी साइन थीटा, राइट? एंड नाउ वी कैन राइट द वैल्यू ऑफ टॉर्क एज माइनस ऑफ आई टाइम्स द एक्सिलरेशन दैट दिस ऑब्जेक्ट इज फेसिंग. ओके, सो दिस इज द मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया, दिस इज द एंगुलर एक्सिलरेशन. ओके, एंड रिमेंबर एंगुलर एक्सिलरेशन is alpha and it is nothing but d square theta by dt square. Okay, and again we are putting a minus sign because it's a restoring torque, right? So it is moving back to its equilibrium position. Okay, and here what we can do is we can make a small angle approximation just like we do it in your case of simple pendulum. And when there is a small angle of displacement from this equilibrium position, we can assume that sine of theta is theta. Okay, so that would mean that this term here will become L m g theta. Okay, and remember d square theta by dt square you can write as theta double dot. Okay, this is another convention of writing double derivative of with respect to angle. Okay, and I just wanted to mention omega. Remember omega is d theta by dt. Okay, and angular acceleration is d square theta by dt square. All right, so now you have your equations. You have torque will be L m g theta, and you will have a minus I. And remember, I we have to mention your moment of inertia with respect to what? So you have with respect to your point P. Okay, so let's write that. So it's better to write that notation. Okay, and alpha is nothing but theta double dot. Okay, so now you should be able to relate this. We are getting equation. If I divide both sides by I will get theta double dot plus L m g divided by I times theta is equal to zero. Okay, so what did I do? I divided both sides by I and then I took the this negative term on the other side and then I get this equation. When you extend the spring, we have a restoring force that the spring is exerting, right, which is minus k times x, okay, where k is the spring constant. Okay, and we did this in the second lab. We found the value of your value of this spring constant, okay, by two methods, static and dynamic method we did. Okay, so this equation that you have here, you can write it in terms of your equation of ma for force. And if you take kx on the other side, you get m d square x by dt square. This term is just acceleration, plus k by m. Okay, if you divide both sides by m and then take this term here, you will get d square x by dt square plus k by mx is equal to zero. Okay, and this equation is the equation of a simple harmonic oscillator. Okay, and this equation has a known solution. Okay, and the known solution to this equation is of the form of a cos omega t plus phi. Okay, So what is happening in this equation? We are having a double derivative of a function which is x. X is position. Okay. So double derivative of this position function plus some factor k by m times the position is equal to 0. Okay. So from here we get the value of the position x. Okay. We are trying to solve for x. So what is x? X is of this form a cos omega t plus phi. Okay. And this is the equation for simple harmonic motion, where you have a is amplitude and you have cos of omega t plus phi, and omega is your frequency of the oscillation. Okay. And it is given by this term square root of k over m. Okay. So it is given by this term k over m, and you have to take a square root of this term. Okay. D square x by dt square plus k by mx is equal to 0. Okay. What is this equation telling you? That if you substitute some value of x here, and if that x is a valid value, then you should get 0. X equal to a cos omega t plus phi is the solution. So we are assuming that. And then to prove whether it is true or not, you have to plug this inside this equation. Okay. So first thing you have to do is you have to calculate d square x by dt square. Okay. So first we have to take single derivative dx by dt, and if we take single derivative, then you get a times minus sine omega t plus phi, and again you have to take the derivative of this function inside d omega t by dt, and so you get this expression minus a omega sine omega t plus phi. अब इसका एक और डेरिवेटिव लेंगे हम, तो वी गेट माइनस ए ओमेगा कॉस ओमेगा टी प्लस फाइव टाइम्स ओमेगा, सो यू गेट बेसिकली माइनस ए ओमेगा स्क्वायर कॉस ओमेगा टी प्लस फाइव. ओके. एंड हियर ए कॉस ओमेगा टी प्लस फाइव वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिफाइंड एज एक्स, सो यू गेट डी स्क्वायर एक्स बाई डी टी स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू माइनस ओमेगा स्क्वायर एक्स. ओके. एंड देन यू टेक इट ऑन द राइट हैंड साइड एंड देन यू गेट दिस इक्वेशन डी स्क्वायर एक्स बाई डी टी स्क्वायर प्लस ओमेगा स्क्वायर एक्स इज इक्वल टू जीरो. ओके. सो नाउ यू हैव अ वन टू वन रिलेशनशिप. वन इक्वेशन इज सेइंग डी स्क्वायर एक्स बाई डी टी स्क्वायर प्लस के बाई एम एक्स इज इक्वल टू जीरो, दैट इज इक्वेशन वन. एंड यू हैव अ सेकेंड इक्वेशन, इट इज टेलिंग यू डी स्क्वायर एक्स बाई डी टी स्क्वायर प्लस ओमेगा स्क्वायर एक्स इज इक्वल टू जीरो. सो देन वट विल बी द रिलेशनशिप? ओमेगा स्क्वायर हैज टू बी इक्वल टू के ओवर एम. इफ ओमेगा स्क्वायर इज के ओवर एम, देन this equation is the same as this equation and this condition is valid, and that's how you get omega is square root of k over m. So what is this equation describing? This is equation is describing something doing simple harmonic motion, right? यहाँ पे जो एनिमेशन तुम्हें दिख रहा है, दिस एनिमेशन इज ऑफ अ सिंपल हार्मोनिक मोशन. ओके. एन ऑब्जेक्ट गोइंग बैक एंड फोर्थ अबाउट इट्स मीन पोजिशन. ओके. एंड दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट मोशन इन फिजिक्स एंड इन ऑल ऑफ साइंस. ओके. इट्स एवरीवेयर इन नेचर. ओके. पीरियड विद विच वी ब्लिंक आर आईज. ओके. इट इज लाइक अ सिंपल हार्मोनिक मोशन. ओके. द रिदम विद विच आर हार्ट इज बीटिंग. ओके. दैट कैन बी अज्यूम टू बी अ सिंपल हार्मोनिक मोशन. ओके. द वे द एटम्स आर वाइब्रेटिंग. ओके. यू कैन अज्यूम देम टू बी अ सिंपल हार्मोनिक मोशन. ओके. द वे दिस पार्टिकल यू सी इज डूइंग अ सर्कुलर मोशन, यू कैन इमेजिन दिस एज अ इलेक्ट्रॉन गोइंग अराउंड अ न्यूक्लियस. ओके. अगेन सिंपल हार्मोनिक मोशन. ऑलराइट. यू कैन अज्यूम दैट सन इज इन द सेंटर एंड अर्थ इज गोइंग अराउंड द सन. अगेन सिंपल हार्मोनिक मोशन. सो इट इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू अंडरस्टैंड द इक्वेशन ऑफ सिंपल हार्मोनिक ऑसिलेटर. समझे? सो ये इक्वेशन हमेशा याद रखना है कि डबल डेरिवेटिव ऑफ अ फंक्शन प्लस सम कांस्टेंट टाइम्स द फंक्शन इज इक्वल टू जीरो, दिस इज अ सिंपल हार्मोनिक ऑसिलेटर इक्वेशन. ओके. एंड दिस इक्वेशन हैज नोन सॉल्यूशन दैट एनी साइन कर्व और अ कोसाइन कर्व ऑफ दिस फॉर्म विल बी अ सॉल्यूशन. ओके. आई जस्ट शोड यू दैट इट इज अ सॉल्यूशन. ओके. प्रोवाइडेड दिस कंडीशन दैट ओमेगा विच इज द फ्रीक्वेंसी हैज टू बी इक्वल टू स्क्वेयर रूट ऑफ दिस कॉन्स्टेंट. ओके. सो ओमेगा हैज टू बी इक्वल टू स्क्वेयर रूट ऑफ दिस कॉन्स्टेंट, देन दिस ऑब्जेक्ट कैन डू सिंपल हार्मोनिक मोशन. ओके. सो नाउ वी हैव टू अप्लाई द सेम आइडिया टू आर सिचुएशन ऑफ आर compound pendulum. So you see, now you have displacement, again double derivative of a function plus some constant term lmg by I times the function is equal to zero. Okay, so this again is of the form of simple harmonic oscillator. Okay, and what did we say? This omega has to be equal to like the square root of this function. Okay, so what do we get? We get omega should be equal to square root of lmg by I. Okay, and we should use that suffix p here. You see, so now we have a frequency of oscillation of this pendulum. We don't need to solve this, we already know the solution. We just have to remember that this is the equation of a simple harmonic oscillator. This is also of the same form. Instead of k over m, we have lmg over I. Okay, and from here you can remember that time period is 2 pi divided by omega. That is a basic definition of what a time period is of the oscillation, okay, of a simple harmonic oscillation. And so that you get 2 pi divided by this term. So you get 2 pi and then you get square root of I divided by mgl. Okay, all we need to know is we need to know I of an object. So whatever object shape it is, if we know the value of I, then we can find the time period of its oscillation. Okay, so all we have to do now is, for our case where we have a continuous bar pendulum, okay, so we don't have this edge shape like this, it's a continuous bar like this. So for this we need to calculate your value of moment of inertia. Okay, and that is a known value. Okay, and the known value is your I through the center of gravity plus ml square. Okay, so here we are going to substitute this known value into this same equation, and from there we get our equation for time period in terms of the total length of the pendulum. Okay, you can square both sides, so you get t square is equal to 4 pi square l by g. Okay, because this is a square root term. Okay, and that's all you need. So what we'll do in the experiment, we will measure the time period of oscillations. We know the length of the pendulum, and so from there we can find the value of g, okay, which is acceleration due to gravity. Okay, and once you have g, then you can also calculate this k, which is your radius of gyration. Okay, so this is the table that you have. Okay, we have to measure the distance l from each point of from the center of gravity. Remember, you have 19 holes, so you start in the middle, which is the 10th hole. So when you go to the 11th hole, you are going basically 5 centimeters in the up direction. Then you go to the second hole, so you are going 10 centimeters and so on. So 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45. And then you can come down on the second half. Okay. So we have the simulator. I want to show you guys where you can perform this experiment. Again, this link is provided in the presentation. Okay. So we have our compound pendulum here. Its mass is given, it's 1 kg. Okay, so I can just displace it by using my mouse a little bit and let go. So it will start doing some oscillations. You see, I can choose the length to be, let's say, 10 centimeters. And if I move the length, you see the pivot point is shifting from where the object is oscillating. So let's do it 25 centimeters. Okay, and 0, 5, 10, 15, 20. So 25 centimeters from the top. Okay, that's how it's measuring. And let's say I want to give it some deviation from the center. Okay, and there you go, it starts oscillating. Okay, and then I want to start. There you go, it started right time. So I have 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10 oscillations. Okay, so there you go. So I stopped at 12.653, so that is my time for 10 oscillations. Okay, so you have to be a little bit careful because there might be some source of error as to when you hit the start and stop times. So take a couple of readings for every length setting that you have. Okay, and once you do that, you can go back to your table, and in the table you can enter your information for your time taken. So you can take two values of time, okay, t1 and t2, and then take the average. Okay, and generally we do for 20 oscillations, so you can then divide by 20 and you will get the time period for each oscillation. Okay, and once you have the time period for each oscillation, then basically you can calculate your value of g. Okay, and what we have to do is we have to plot this value of time that we are getting here, all the time periods, with respect to the length from the center of your position of gravity. Okay, so you will get a symmetric curve on both the sides, something like this. Okay, and what we have to do is we have to draw a line on the graph which has to be parallel to this bottom line, which is your distance. Okay, and from here you have to do your length measurement on your graph scale. Okay, so basically what we have here is you have a value of let's say L here, okay, L1, okay, and you have some value of L1 here. Okay, so you can add these and then take the average. Similarly, you have a value of L2, which will be your value from this position all the way to this position. Okay, so that will be your L2 value. And similarly, you will have a L2 value on the other side for this point and from the center of gravity. Okay, so that will be L2. Then you take the average of the two L2 values, and then you take the average of this L1 plus L2, and then that's how you get the total length of the pendulum. Okay, so you have to draw a line so that it is intersecting on both the sides of the curve, and so it has to intersect on these four distinct points. Okay, and from there you get the length values, and the center point here will give you the value of the time period. Okay, and that is what you use in your calculation to find your value of g. Okay, so L, you see, is AD plus BE by 2. So that's how you calculate and you get your value of G. Okay, like I mentioned, this is the link for the simulator. And there is a very detailed video available online for you to perform this experiment. Okay, and the link has been provided as well. So you can go on this link and you can see the detailed video as well. Okay.